It's a great pleasure to be your speaker tonight and support this. And I would like to introduce first Aleksandra, who loves Mihajlo Pupin, and I am completely impressed with her, you know, research and everything what she did. She's the president of Educational Research Society of Mihajlo Pupin, ambassador of UNESCO Club of Sorbonne, and founder of the first virtual museum in Belgrade. So, hi, Aleksandra.
Hi.
Welcome to our panel. And just quick thing, I just want to say that also we are going to do a fundraiser. That's also the reason why we are all here. And it's about outstanding school, music school in Gnjilane, Stevan Hristić. We have 500 kids over there with amazing talent. They won a lot of awards. I listened to their concert, and you had a chance like to listen in the beginning of this panel. And I really want to do something and to support those kids as you do, as because that's why you are here. And thank you very much for being with us tonight. Aleksandra, here you go and enjoy.
Thank you very much. You are right. I love Mihajlo Pupin. How not to love such an exquisite man. Good soul, good heart. This funding is just like Mihajlo Pupin. Would he be alive? Yes, he would take care about the musical school, and we wouldn't care about that. So, if we talk about Mihajlo Pupin, this is the best way to talk. Please, if you didn't, please read his three books, From Immigrant to Inventor, a Pulitzer Prize winning book in 1924, New Reformation, that's a true closeness in science and religion, and Romance of the Machine, Hemingway's famous book. Please read Mihajlo Pupin. His words are better than ours. In Serbian, in English, in Japanese, his words are the best ones. I would just read what Lion Fels commented in 1934 in the Washington Post, saying about Pupin's From Immigrant to Inventor. An exciting as any scientific discovery, and reveals one of the most charming and kindest personalities of the 20th century. Yes, most kind, most humble, most brilliant personality of 20th century, all in one. So it's not easy for me to speak about Mihajlo Pupin. He was only 13 years old when he asked his mother, "Mother, please tell me what is light." And she told him, "My son, I never went to school. I don't know to write and read. I don't know what is light. You have to go to the world and to find answers on that huge questions." So, with 14 years, he left Idvor and trying to find that huge answers about light, about sound, but he never loses in this trip, life-winning trip, he never loses his kind heart. So, for me, what is Mihajlo Pupin to me? Brilliant and kind heart. And that's the first topic. Trust me, I know a lot about history of science, not just of the world. And in huge histories of science, there are few that heart is bigger than mind. In Pupin case, heart is bigger than mind. Please, once more time, read his books, From Immigrant to Inventor, New Reformation and Romance of the Machine, and then you will see him in close. He will be just near you. I would like to say hi to Mr. Barry. He is with us tonight. Tonight in Serbian time, during American time, watching it's daylight, but darkness is here. Thank you, Barry. You represent Norfolk. If you want to go close to Pupin, go to Norfolk. He's American Idvor. His soul lives there more than in any other place, more than his Columbia University, his New York, but Norfolk's place in heart is huge. One more thing I would like to read. Yasmina would tell you that only him in American science, only him won all three American scientific prizes. The John Frick, the Edison Medal, and the third one. And when the John Frick Medal was delivered to him, Bancroft Geraldi, huge scientist, said, in the late winter of 1874, a young Serb landed in Castle Garden. He was, look at this, he was without property or possession, without friends or money, without influence, without anything, without knowledge. But you would say he was without nothing, and you would be wrong. Many would say he had nothing, but please, please, said Bancroft Geraldi, recognize of the things he bring with himself. Good health, good character, ambition, mind, eager to find knowledge and to use it for good, I would say, and as well as high ideals. In that words, you can find a recipe for Michael Pupin. High ideals, good heart, courage. He was hungry. It was cold. He was alone. He was penniless. But he started like a poor young man. But then, few decades later, he was president of New York Academy of Science, president of three different big societies in America. He was great professor at Columbia. I found the names of four Nobel Prizes, his students. That was all great. But then I see a letter from 1990. He was going to Paris for a peace conference. He was everything. Academician, he was president, he was professor, and they gave him a passport for one day, but I saw a paper. Your name, full name, and what are you doing? Full name, Mihajlo Idvorski Pupin. He wrote zemljoradnik, farmer, wrote farmer, academician, professor, president, farmer. Oh, Michael Pupin, he was not kidding. He really, really, really knew that this first step was the last one also. He always was a simple and very, very close man for not three foundations, four foundations. And again, letter, after Communist Party in here, nothing left. He left a lot, but after 1946, after Second World War, nothing left on accounts on his foundation. Fourth foundation, he writes to president, you see, thank you very much for what you are doing. You have a daughter, and I bought her some necklace. I hope she like it. Please, from Michael Pupin to her with love. So who would ask, who would who would said that? Who would done that? No one. His simple, simple mind. He said, the first goal of science is to interpret the language of nature, and without any prejudice. This leads us to understanding that gives us the insight info, the eternal truth, and truth will make us free. And truth will make us free. My struggle for 15 years is to find truth about Mihajlo Pupin, about his relations to Nikola Tesla, about great Ivan Jaya, about Milutin Milanković. Finding truth is a big, big job to do. So 15 years, I'm revealing truth about great scientists, that heart is greater than mind, and they were brilliant. Brilliant in thinking, but brilliant in working good deeds for all humanity. So, you will sorry for my English, because I'm always struggling with emotions when I talk about Mihajlo Pupin. He was, for me, because of the virtues, a saint man, not in the religious type, in human type. He was a good man, taking care about others. Big, big, big Christian day in Norfolk, on the big table, on one side, Rockefeller, Carnegie, very wealthy American people. On the other side, very, 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 with small money account, people from Trebinje, from Herzegovina, and he puts meat in oven. And he serves the very wealthy American people and these very humble people from Herzegovina. They all worked on his property in Norfolk. Mr. Berry, I hope you know that there are lots of small houses around Pupin's big house. The people from Serbia worked very, very hard, and he was the best man for Serbian interests during the first part of 20th century. I would like to say many years. In first part of 20th century, he was the face, he was the strength. He was humanitarian like no other. All his life from the beginning of 20th century to his death, he just gives. For 15 years, every week, I got more proof about his good deeds, thousands of them. One professor from economic faculty listens to me and said, Aleksandra, give me his good deeds. I will tell you how we can see them from money point of view today, how it works today. And he called me and said, something is wrong here. I said, yes, it's a small list. It's not a full list. I send you what I have. And he says to me, this, your small list is $2 billion. $2 billion. His money, his friend's money, for many decades, only giving for boys, for girls, for institutions, for archaeological research, for books, for, yes, I'm sure, for music. Tonight, we spend this time surrounding by music, And he, from all our scientists, he played the best. He played frula. I don't know how to say in English. This instrument, somebody will help me. Frula, gaite.
Flute.
Yes.
Used to play.
Gusle.
Flute. Flute.
Float, float, gusle.
I'm not sure how you say gusle, yeah.
Yes, gaide.
Gaide is bagpipes.
I orgule.
Organ.
Yes, organ. He played exquisite. I just think about that boat from Europe to America. He was a young man, 20 years old. Only in Košulja. Yes, he was very modest. Only one pair of t-shirt, and then everybody saw him, young man, let him go to the chimney. 3 weeks he was holding chimney. And Pupin wrote, I know, my mother is now praying, and God will listen to her, so I will see America. I know I will see America. Without knowledge of one word in English. That's how he came to America. Just good faith, good heart. He didn't lose his good heart in his struggle. His struggle, great struggle, great courage, and good heart that is light motive of Michael Pope. So, read his words. I would like to say just that. If you want to see him in close, read his words. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Aleksandra. That was great. I'm really amazed always with your information. You have so many things to share, and I know I listen to your YouTube channels and everything. It's great. And I will suggest to all people, if you can, but it's in Serbian, of course, just listen, Aleksandra, also in Serbian. It's really great.
If you can, to listen something in Serbian, try to Google Pupin fairy tale. Pupin of a bike. Try to watch it. I think it is the best.
That's beautiful. Thank you. One thing that really stuck to me when I was reading his biography was how he was talking about his mother. That was something that really is still with me. Every time, even when he was old gentleman, he would stand up every time when he would mention his mother. And something really stuck also to me because my mother sacrificed a lot of stuff to give me education, you know, and that's something in our Serbian mother that really cares a lot. And I really am proud on all our Serbian mothers. So thank you so much, Aleksandra, one more time.